Proverbs 18,
uh-huh.
The Spirit of the Most High is upon me.
And this is who the world calls Christ speaking, huh? The Spirit is upon him as it's on upon us right now. For what reason? Read.
Because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor.
To who?
To the poor.
We're out here to preach the gospel to the poor, read.
He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted.
Uh-huh.
To preach deliverance to the captives.
We're preaching deliverance to the captives out here, man. Who are the captives? You, the captives are you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You're the captives.
That's right.
And you've always been the captives. In every single superpower and every single empire, you have been the captives, man. That's why who the world calls Christ, Yahweh Shai, is quoting something that's already been written, man. Give me that idea. Because during the time of Yahweh Shai, the children of Israel were captive unto the Romans, man, the Greeks, the so-called white man. Right? In the time of Isaiah, they were under captivity under the Babylonians, man. Which would be Cushites or Ethiopians as we know them today.
This is Isaiah chapter 61 verse 1.
Read.
The Spirit of the Most High power is upon me.
Uh-huh.
Because the Most High hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek.
Unto who?
Unto the meek.
Read.
He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted.
Uh-huh.
To proclaim liberty to the captives.
Proclaim liberty to the captives. Once again, the captives are you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You are the captives.
That's right.
You're the ones who are possessed by another people, man. That's why you carry another people's name.
That's right.
All right? Read on.
To proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of the prison to them that are bound.
And the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Nobody is in the prison more than the black, Hispanic, and Native American, man. America has the highest population of prisoners in jail on all earth, man. And guess who fills up that those jails? Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. We're out here to proclaim liberty to you, man. Alright? Give me Isaiah 42 and 23.
This is Isaiah chapter 42, verse 22.
Uh-huh.
But this is a people wrought and spoiled.
And that's what we've been sent out to. We've been sent out to a people who have been robbed and spoiled, man. The so-called Hispanic, the so-called Native American has been robbed and spoiled of his land, man. The so-called black man has been robbed and spoiled of his freedom. We are a people robbed and spoiled, man. Because we are the children of Israel. And it was prophesied that we would be robbed and spoiled. Why? We don't.
And they are in prison houses.
Uh-huh.
They are for a prey.
Uh-huh.
And none delivering.
No one is delivering us, man. Just today, a black man was killed in his own apartment because some dumbass devil cracker thought it was his apartment, went in there and saw him and shot his ass to death, man.
And none says restore.
And nobody says restore, man. Nobody says help these people, man. Nobody gives a damn about you.
Who among you will give ear to this?
And that's the question. Who among you blacks and you Hispanics will give ear to this, man? The brothers you see before you heard the affliction and gave ear to it, man. And now we're coming out here week in and week out to do this work to heal our people, man. And bring them back to the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding that they are the children of Israel that the Bible speaks of, man.
That's
and that they
great.
Need to keep the law, statutes, and commandments so that they might be saved from this place. Read on.
Who gave Jacob for a spoil?
Who gave Jacob for a spoil, man? Who did it? Did the white man do it of his own power, of his own self? Hell no, man. The white man could never destroy blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans of his own knowledge, of his own power, of his own self, man. So who gave us up, man? Who's the one who delivered us to this devil, man? You know?
And Israel to the robbers.
Read.
Is not the Most High?
The Most High did it, man. This white man could never do this of on his own, man. He could never pull this off of his own.
Why?
Because he's the basis of men. Matter of fact, give me that in Daniel 7:4 and 17.
Hold that.
This matter is by the decree of the watcher, and to the man by the word of the Holy One, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High rules in the kingdom of men.
The Most High rules in the kingdom of men. That's why black people went extinct. That's why Hispanics and Native Americans lost their land. Because the Most High decided that that was what's going to happen, man. Not because the white man is powerful, not because the white man is intelligent, it's because the Most High said it, man. You know?
And giveth it to whomsoever he will, and setteth up over it the basis of men.
And that's who's been set up over it, man. That's who's been set up over all the earth, the basis of men. The most simplest of people, man. The so-called white man. Right? So he could never have done this of his own power, of his own intelligence, of his own strength, man. The Most High made it so that he could prevail over us. Get back to Isaiah.
Isaiah 42 and 24, who gave Jacob for a spoil,
and
Israel to the robbers.
Read.
Did not the Most High?
The Most High did it, go ahead.
He against whom we have sinned.
And that's why. This is why we're in this position. This is why we fill up the prisons. This is why we fill up the ghettos. This is why we're in the reservations. Read that, read what?
For they would not walk in his ways.
For we would not walk in the ways of the Most High, read.
Neither were they obedient unto his law.
That's the main reason, man. That's the main reason we're under this devil today, man. Because we were not obedient to the laws of the Most High God. That's the main reason. Is that it on that? That's the 25?
Oh, no. Therefore, he hath poured upon him the fury of his anger.
That's why the fury has been poured out on us, man. And what's the fury? Slavery. Being gunned down in the streets, gunning each other down. That's the fury, man. Read on. Is that it?
And the strength of battle, and it has set him on fire round about, yet he knew not, and it burned him, yet he laid it not to heart.
That's what it's like. Give me 1:1. Alright, we sin against the Most High, man. Actually, give me 1 John 3:4. Alright? What does it mean to sin? You just explained it there. We were not obedient to the law, but we gotta beat it into your heads, man. Give me sin.
This is 1 John 3:4. Whosoever committed sin transgresseth also the law.
If you're sinning, because you are a direct transgression of the law, read.
For sin is a transgression of the law.
So when you transgress the laws of God, because that's what we're talking about up here. We're not talking about no white man's laws, man. We're not talking about the government's laws. We're talking about the laws of the Most High God, the Creator of the earth. When you are in transgression of the Most High's laws, you are in sin. Alright? Give me Deuteronomy 1:1.
Chapter 1:1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
These are the words which Moses spake to all Israel, man. You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you're Israel. According to history, according to archaeology, most importantly, according to the prophecies within the Bible, man. Alright, get Deuteronomy 28:15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Most High thy power, to observe to do all his commandments.
All his commandments, read.
And his statutes,
uh-huh.
which I command thee this day.
Read.
That all these curses.
All these what?
That all these curses.
Read.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
And all these curses have come upon us and overtaken us because we have not hearkened unto the voice of the Most High, man.
That's right.
Like we've been reading, all we've been doing is being in idolatry and being faggots and drug dealers. That's all we've been doing out here, man. And that's why we fill up the prison houses. That's why we're destroyed out here in Canada and America, man. Because we have not hearkened unto the voice of the Most High.
That's right.
Instead, we hearken unto the voice of the basis of man, the so-called white man.
Yeah.
All right? Give me Jeremiah 16:11.
This is Jeremiah chapter 16, verse 11.
Uh-huh.
Then shalt thou say unto them,
really?
Because your fathers have forsaken me.
Uh-huh.
Thus saith the Most High, and have walked after other gods.
That's the chief problem with our people today, man. The chief problem is that we have walked after other gods. Alright, the chief God that we walk after, opposed to our own power, the creator of all things, man, Yahweh, is this God that devil sees the boy here, man.
That's right.
That's the main God that we follow, man. The white man. Read on.
And have served them, and have worshipped them, and have forsaken me,
uh-huh.
and have not kept my law.
Uh-huh.
And ye have done worse than your father.
And that's what's been systematically happening. Every generation is getting worse and worse, man. Alright? You had back in the day, you couldn't even walk around and say that you were a faggot, man.
That's
now
right.
You can go and say you're a faggot and everybody likes you, everybody thinks you're cool, man.
Right.
It's the cool thing to be, man. To be a transvestite and all these abominable, detestable things, man.
Right.
Because each generation has been getting worse and worse. Read that again.
And have served them, and have worshipped them, and have forsaken me, and have not kept my law.
Because we didn't keep the law, read.
And ye have done worse than your fathers.
And that's what we've been doing. Worse and worse than our fathers.
Are you guys Christian?
No, we're Hebrew Israelites.
Jews?
Yeah. Oh. So, brother, what's your nationality?
For me?
Yeah.
Trinidad.
You're from Trinidad, right?
We're Christians.
So let me ask you this. Well, Christian is a religion, right?
Yeah.
I'm asking his nationality.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Trinidad is not a nationality. Because your people were not always called Trinidadians, right? Your people were called Trinidadians by the people who brought them to Trinidad. How were your people brought to Trinidad? How were your people brought to Trinidad, brother?
Are you right?
I'm sorry?
How were they brought?
I don't know, by ships.
By ships, right? They were brought in ships for what? For what purpose? To serve slavery, right? Now, according to the Bible, God's chosen people would go into slavery the exact same way that the Trinidadians went into slavery. Right? And what we're out here teaching is that Trinidadians, Haitians, Hispanics, all these people that suffered slavery are in fact the true people of God. We're not Ecuadorians, we're not Mexicans, we're not Trinidadians, Haitians. We're in fact the chosen people of God. And I'm going to show you the slave ships in the Bible that I'm going to teach you.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Most High shall bring thee into Egypt.
Into Egypt, right? The children of Israel were in Egypt doing what? Slavery, right? Read.
Again.
Again, read.
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
With ships, read.
By the way, whereof I spake unto thee,
uh-huh.
thou shalt see it no more again.
And our people never saw their homeland again after they went to slavery, read.
And there. Ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
And there you shall be what?
Sold unto your enemies.
Brother, you're a Hebrew Israelite. You're not a Christian. You need to come back to the last statute commandment of the Most High God. Alright?
We're at churches.
We're right here every Friday. Alright? Bring your Bible.
Alright.
Alright, brother. Alright, man. Start it over again.
This is Jeremiah chapter 16, verse 11.
Uh-huh.
Then shalt thou say unto them, because your fathers have forsaken me,
read,
saith the Most High, and have walked after other gods.
Yep, we walked after other gods, chiefly Caesar Bolger, chiefly the white man, who is the devil that the Bible speaks of. Read.
and have served them and have worshipped them.
And that's what we do, man. We serve them and we worship them, man. Read.
And have forsaken me and have not kept my law.
We have not kept what?
My law.
We have not kept the law, read.
And ye have done worse than your father.
And that's what's been happening, man. That's what's been systematically happening. We've been doing worse and worse and worse. As every generation goes by, we become worse and worse, man. Not too long ago, you couldn't walk the streets and say that you're a faggot, man. Look, you couldn't walk the streets and say you're a tranny, man. But because we've been getting worse and worse and worse, now that's an acceptable thing. Now you can walk up and down the street, call yourself a tranny, call yourself a faggot, and everybody applauds you, man. But let you say that you follow the laws of God and you want to have more than one wife and you're evil and you're wicked, man. But you could be a faggot, though. That's how upside down this place is, man. That's how systematically worse and worse every generation has been getting, man. Read that again.
Verse 12. And ye have done worse than your fathers.
And we have done worse than our fathers.
For behold, he walked every one after the imagination of his evil heart.
And that's the thing, man. Everybody in this place wants to follow their heart. Everybody wants to love everybody. But doesn't understand that the Bible, the Word of God, says that your heart is evil, man. Get that precept.
This is Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9.
Read.
The heart is deceitful above all things.
The heart is deceitful above all things, man. In your heart, you want to be at peace with everybody and hold hands with everybody and love everybody, man. Because your heart is wicked, man. And deceitful. Your heart has you deceived that there can be such thing as peace on earth when there can never be peace on earth. Because there has never been peace on earth, man.
That's right.
And there will never be peace on earth until the reign of Yahweh Shai Mashiach, man. And until when the extermination of the so-called white man comes to pass, man. Then the earth will know peace, man. The Bible says that the trees and the animals will rejoice when there's not one white man left on this earth.
That's right.
Because all you do is destroy everything, man. Get that destroyed.
Get that one, cut it down, or the power that he needs.
It's all good. Go back to Jeremiah. That
Jeremiah chapter 16 verse 12.
Uh-huh.
And ye have done worse than your fathers.
Read.
For behold, ye walk every one after the imagination of his evil heart, that they may not hearken unto me.
And that's the thing, man. You want to do every other thing except follow the laws of God, except follow the Holy Bible. You want to act like you believe in God, act like you believe in Jesus. But when the Most High's word is read, all of a sudden, oh no, 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 we can't do that. Oh no, 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 things have changed. Oh no, no, no. All of a sudden, there's a problem. Because you seek after your own heart, man. Give me Isaiah 30 and 1. Morning, man. And that's what's coming to you, rebellious children. You blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans, you are the children of the Most High God. But you are rebellious, man. You refuse to listen to the words of God. And what does the Bible say? Read that again.
Woe to the rebellious children.
Woe, meaning destruction and mourning. That's why we mourn all the time, man. That's why we're always mourning about our dead brothers and sisters. Because we are rebellious children, man.
That take counsel, but not of me.
And that's the thing, man. Our people seek counsel from everything under the sun except the Lord, man. Except the prophets of the Lord. Chiefly, once again, who you seek the most counsel from is the so-called white man, the basis of the earth, the children of fools, man.
That's right.
Did you know that?
But but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin.
And that's what you do here in this place, man. You add sin to sin. Give me Hosea, the 5th chapter, 12th verse.
Hosea, chapter 5, verse 12. Therefore will I be unto Ephraim as a moth.
Ephraim, right? Ephraim is the head tribe of the northern kingdom of Israel. And it represents the entirety of the northern kingdom of Israel, which is you Hispanics and you Native Americans, right? You so-called indigenous people of the Americas, you're Ephraim. Read that again.
Hosea 5 and 12. Therefore will I be unto Ephraim as a moth.
And that's what the Most High has been unto Ephraim, man. That's what the Most High has been unto you, man. A moth. A bother, man. To say the least. Read.
And to the house of Judah as rottenness.
Judah. You so-called Negroes, man. You Haitians, you Negroes, and you West Indians. He's been a rottenness to you. Read.
When Ephraim saw his sickness and Judah saw his wound, then went Ephraim to the Syrians and sent to King Jerob. Yet could he not heal you, nor cure you of your wound.
And that's the thing, man. Our people seek after other nations to heal us, man. To make us whole again. We seek after these other nations that have done nothing but rape, rob, and murder us, man. But we will never seek after the Most High God. That's why we're destroyed, man. That's why 400 plus families have been torn apart at the damn American-Mexican border, man. Alright? Read.
For I will be able to eat from as a lion.
Uh-huh.
And as a young lion to the house of Judah.
Read.
I will tear and go away.
Uh-huh.
I will take away and none shall rescue.
No one's gonna rescue you, man. The white man cannot rescue you. None of these nations can rescue you from this, right? Only the Most High God, through His Son, can rescue you, man. Ready on that? All right, give me Isaiah 59 and 1.
This is Isaiah chapter 59, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Behold, the Most High's hand is not shortened that it cannot save.
The Most High's hand is not short, man. He can save you up out of this. Read.
Neither his ear heavy that it cannot hear.
He can hear you. He hears everything that you're saying. He hears all your prayers. He hears all your cries, man. Read.
But your iniquities have separated between you and your power.
And that's the problem, man. All this wickedness, all the iniquity that you've done because the so-called white man says you can't, has separated you from your power, man, from your God. Give me this prayer. That's the problem. You'd rather eat pork than be saved, man. You'd rather be a faggot. You'd rather sell drugs. You'd rather sleep with your brother's wife than be saved. And that's the problem. Read that.
This is Proverbs chapter 28, verse 9.
Huh?
He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law.
If you turn your ear from hearing the words of the Most High God, read.
Even his prayer shall be an abomination.
Your prayer is an abomination, man. He's not gonna hear you. He's gonna hear you, but he's not gonna hear you. If you can understand. Go back to that.
This is Isaiah 59 and 1.
Uh-huh.
Behold, the Most High's hand is not shortened that it cannot save.
Read.
Neither his ear heavy that it cannot hear.
Read.
But your iniquities have separated between you and your power.
Your iniquities, you blacks and Hispanics and you Native Americans, your iniquities have separated you from your God, man. Read.
And your sins have hid his face from you that he will not hear.
He will not hear you. So long as you're in the midst of sin, the Lord will not hear you, man. You mean that's the four?
For your hands are defiled with blood.
And that's the thing. A lot of our people, their hands are defiled with blood. Our people murder each other so goddamn much, man. It's disgusting. It's absolutely disgusting. Our people's hands are what?
For your hands are defiled with blood.
Our hands are defiled with blood. Read on.
And your fingers with iniquity.
Uh-huh.
Your lips have spoken lies.
Uh-huh.
Your tongue hath muttered perverseness.
Read.
None calleth for justice, nor any pleadeth for truth.
And that's the thing, man. We see our people dying in the streets, and we don't even call for justice. We don't give a damn, man. We care more about them white people in the rap industry beefing with each other, man. That's what we care about. But we don't call for justice. That's all our people do, man. Just be the most wicked, vilest thing on the earth. Alright? Give me Ezekiel 36 chapter.
Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 16.
Read.
Moreover, the word of the Most High came unto me, saying, Son of man,
read.
When the house of Israel dwelt in their own land, they defiled it by their own way and by their doings.
That's what we did, man. We had our land that flowed with milk and honey, the land that the Most High promised to us, and we defiled it by our doings, man. By going after the ways of our own hearts.
That's right.
By seeking after these other goddamn filthy heathen ass nations, man.
That's right.
And we lost our land because of it, man. And it's been happening a time and a time again, man. You know?
They defiled it by their own way and by their doing.
Read.
Their way was before me as the uncleanness of a removed woman.
Right, read.
Wherefore I poured my fury upon them for the blood that they had shed upon the land and for the idols wherewith they have polluted.
Read.
And I scattered them among the heathen.
And that's what's happened to our people, man. We've been scattered among these heathen. Scattered among the white devils. Scattered among these Arabs. Scattered among these Africans. Scattered among these goddamn groups, man. We've been scattered among the heathen because of our iniquity, read.
And they were dispersed through the country according to their way. And according to their doing, I judged them.
Read.
And when they entered into the heathen, whither they went, they profaned my holy name. When they said to them, these are the people of the Most High, and are gone forth out of his land. But I had pity for my holy name, which the house of Israel had profaned among the heathen, whither they went.
And that's what you've done, man. That's what you blacks and you Hispanics have done. You have profaned the name of your God by following after these devil white people, man. By following after these Africans, by following after these Arabs, man. By following after everybody except him. Read.
Therefore, say unto the house of Israel,
read.
Thus saith the Most High Power, I do not this for your sake, O house of Israel, but for my holy name's sake.
The Most High is doing this for his own name's sake, man. He's not doing it for you, he's not doing it for us. He's doing it for his name's sake because he promises for us. And his word does not come back void, man.
Which ye have profaned among the heathen, whither ye went. And I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathen, which ye have profaned in the midst of them, and the heathen shall know that I am the Most High, saith the Most High Power, when I shall be sanctified in you before their eyes.
Read.
For I will take you from among the heathen.
He's going to take us from among the heathen, read.
And gather you out of all the countries, and will bring you into your own land.
And that's what's going to happen, man. But that's not going to happen until you get right with the Lord. That's when that's going to happen, read.
Then will I sprinkle clean water upon you.
Clean water, go ahead.
And ye shall be clean.
Read.
From all your filthiness and from all your idols.
That's the filthiness, man. The filthiness is worshiping some goddamn white devil, man. That's filthy. Alright? The filthiness is worshiping some goddamn rock that some Arab deems holy, man. That's filthy, man.
A new heart also will I give you.
Uh-huh.
And a new spirit will I put within you.
Read.
And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh.
Uh-huh.
And I will give you a heart of flesh.
Read.
And I will put my spirit within you.
Uh-huh.
And cause you to walk in my statutes.
And that's what's gonna happen, man. When we get out of this place, it's because we're gonna be walking in the statutes and the laws and the commandments of the Most High, man. That's 28.
Judgments,
uh-huh.
and do them,
go ahead.
And ye shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers, and ye shall be my people, and I will be your power.
That's when we're gonna get out of here, man. That's when we're gonna be saved and delivered, man. When the Lord is our God, man. Yahweh is our power, not some goddamn devil cracker, man. Give me 1 Kings 8, the 8th chapter. Sorry? It's a scarf, it's cold. Yeah. My head can't be covered.
This is 1 Kings chapter 8 verse 47.
Uh-huh.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves.
That's what needs to happen, man. You blacks and you Hispanics need to bethink yourselves and think, what the hell am I doing, man? What the hell am I doing following after white people? What the hell am I doing listening to this Christianity garbage? What the hell am I doing, man, selling drugs to my people? What the hell am I doing worshiping some goddamn white man when the Bible says that Jesus Christ was a black man?
Rastafari.
What the hell am I doing, man, worshiping some Ethiopian in Rastafari, man? What the hell am I doing? You need to bethink yourself, black man, Hispanic man, Native American man, worshiping some goddamn mounts. Worshiping some goddamn totem poles. You need to be thinking to himself, right?
In the land whither they were carried captive,
uh-huh.
And repent and make supplication unto thee in the land of them that carry them captive.
And that's what you need to do, man. You need to repent. That means turn away from doing that. If you're selling drugs, you need to stop selling drugs. If you're worshiping white people, stop worshiping the goddamn devil, man. If you're sleeping with your brother's wife, stop sleeping with your brother's wife, man. Get your own wife.
Saying, we have sinned and have done perversely.
Uh-huh.
We have committed wickedness.
Read.
And so return unto thee with all their heart,
uh-huh.
And with all their soul.
Read.
In the land of their enemies.
Uh-huh. The land of who?
In the land of their enemies.
What's Canada?
The land of their enemy.
What's America?
The land of their enemy.
This is the land of your enemy, man. Your enemy is in possession of this land. And it's his. Who's your enemy? The so-called white man is your enemy, man. The so-called Arab is your enemy. All these people that have benefited from your destruction, those are your enemies, man. Give me Psalms, man. Is that 83? Give me Psalms. Because a lot of you foolish ass blacks and Hispanics and you Native Americans think that the Most High God loves everybody, man. Newsflash, the Most High God hates people, man, and has enemies. Read.
Psalms chapter 83 verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Keep not thou silence, O power.
And that's what we're out here pleading to the Most High not to keep his silence anymore, man. Pleading that the Most High put this white man to death, man. Pleading that the Most High brings this nation down, man. Every day and every night, man, ceaselessly. I pray that this white man dies, man. Read.
Hold not thy peace and be not still, O power.
Uh-huh.
For lo, thy enemies
thy make who?
Thy enemies
read.
Make a tumult.
Uh-huh.
And they that hate thee have lifted up the head.
They that hate thee, man. They lifted up the head at the Most High. Read.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
Read.
And consulted against thy hidden ones.
And who's the hidden ones, man? The hidden ones are you blacks and Hispanics. How do I know? Because you're called blacks and Hispanics. When the Bible calls you the children of Israel, man. But the white man doesn't want you to know that your true nationality, your true name, is the children of Israel. The white man wants you to walk around calling yourself a damn color, man. He wants you to call yourself a Hispanic.
What is it about this spot that people come to this spot to preach? What a religion.
It's a lot of foot traffic, brother. And on that note, what's your nationality?
My nationality?
Yeah.
I'm Benjamin. Don't bring this to me. You're talking
about Benjamin.
I'm 41 and I'm very studied.
So okay. All praises,
right,
man.
Right now, just, you know?
All praises. Hey, I'm just asking. I don't know anybody.
No,
what,
no, no.
You can't tell by just looking at somebody. You feel me? That's
you
why.
Can't,
that's why
I,
I'm asking.
No, my brother. I'm saying I know. I know what you're on. Is what I'm
right,
saying.
Right, right.
I'm much less respectful.
Okay.
I might even stop. Yo, continue.
Right.
Please continue.
All praises, brother.
You understand what I'm saying?
So I would that you would join us out here for our people, man.
You know what? I'm right now. I'm on my way to put my kids and stuff.
I'm not saying like immediately.
You know?
Right now, you know what I'm saying? Like we're out here every Friday. Feel me?
Okay.
We're out here every Friday. All right. So every Friday from 5 till whenever it finishes, we're out here. So I want to see you again, man.
Where else are you guys, like, serious time, where else are you guys going to stand?
Yo, right now, I was just here. We were doing downtown Brampton. But downtown Brampton got a little bit too hectic. Too many fucking white people losing their minds and
what
shit. Cops coming.
From?
It's a car. But what, you with a camp?
I'm not with no camp at all. I don't deal with any organization, to tell you the truth.
Right, right.
It's something that I kind of always knew, which is weird. And then when I grew up and I learned other certain things, and I'm like saying, why did I always know that? But then when I came into more knowledge and I understood why I know and why I know what I know.
Right.
I mean, because I'm one of the sons of the living Most High God.
That's right.
And these things are in me spiritually
that's
to know. And that's why I know what it
is.
You understand what I'm saying? So, like, a lot of that, like, even there's things I even told people, I'm like, why did I say that? And then I come to find out later that, yo, I said it because, like, it wasn't me saying it.
Right.
I can give you some stories, man. Like,
right.
But, like, overall, when it comes to my book, like, of course I can study more, but I am well studied.
Right.
You know, I am very well studied, but, like, all aspects of spirituality.
Right.
We're talking about the battling spirits in terms of, from battling spirits in terms of crazy. Hard walk to follow,
yeah.
But when you're in it every day and you're doing it,
that's right.
Yeah. So, thing is that I'll ask the brothers them to do when they're giving the word. I heard you swear,
right?
You know what I'm saying? I swear a few times before,
right?
You know what I mean? But like, you know, Christ and Spirit, one of the things you ask from us is that like, we don't be like them at all, no matter how they come to you, how they talk to you, don't stoop on a level. Back and reflect them back, like them, spiritually.
Hold on.
You know?
I can could wash my mouth a little bit more with the swearing. Well, Christ himself went back and forth with people and debated with people. And Christ, I'll take it even a step further, Christ insulted people. There was instances where he'd call people fools, he'd call people hypocrites, he'd call people snakes, he'd call a woman a dog, you know what I'm saying? So
he was teaching them a lesson, though.
Yeah.
He was showing them truly what they really, like, throughout their actions and how they live,
right.
Showing them how they really are. Like,
right.
When you're saying, like, you're sleeping around with people.
Right.
Right? That's something that a dog does. And when you look at it, that's something that a dog really does.
Well, basically, a dog.
You get what I'm saying?
Dog,
so he's comparing you
a
to
dog,
like, a dog.
A,
when
a dog is like somebody who's basically lawless, right? Because, like you said, a dog will sleep with anybody.
That's
a dog
the metaphor
will, to a it. Dog will eat anything. You know what I'm saying? It's
that's
like, it's likening him to a beast. Because that's what a beast is, lawless. They'll sleep with anything. A dog goes and hunts anything.
Exactly.
A dog will eat its own vomit
exactly.
off the floor.
Exactly.
Because a dog is lawless. That's
exactly.
why he was likening
that,
that woman unto that, man.
I love what you guys are on, man. This is really my day right now, seeing you guys.
Hey, it makes my day to meet
up.
You. What's your name, brother?
Omar.
Okay.
Yeah,
well,
my friends call me
Omar. Yeah, I'm Pagaya Allah. His brother's Awar.
Okay.
Right?
I like it.
Yeah, so, hey, like I said, if you got a cool, I understand. But we out here every Friday this time. So I would love to see you again, man. Come back with your sword.
I'll come back and ride
you. Okay. And check. Have you heard of Sicari?
Nah.
So search it up when you got free time, whatever, you know. Just search it up, Sicari.
You guys have like a base or something, like a one, like two, three, five, three, come back.
No, we're the only brothers out here right now. We're trying to build it up. Sicari is based out of the West Coast, out of San Diego. It's with a, I don't know if you're a Gorilla Eagle. Search him up. Search it up. That's who we rocking with. Alright, brother?
sure.
Hey, all praise.
Psalms chapter 83 verse 1. Keep not thou silence, O power.
And that's what we're doing. We're out here asking the Most High to stop keeping silence, man. To start killing these devils, man. Read.
Hold not thy peace. And be not still, O power. For lo, thy enemies make a tumult.
Read.
And they that hate thee have lifted up their head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
And that's what they've done. They've taken crafty counsel against our people, read.
And consulted against thy hidden ones.
And that's you. You're the hidden ones. You're the hidden ones. You're called black, you're called Hispanic, you're called Native American. In an attempt to hide who you really are, they call you these bywords and these proverbs, man. Because in fact, you are the children of Israel, the Most High God, man.
That's right.
The people that the Bible speaks about, the people that the Bible was written by, that's you, black man. That's you, Hispanics. And that's you, Native Americans, man. You're not niggas, you're not spicks, you're not none of those things. You are the children of the Most High God. But the so-called white man has had, the so-called white man has it in with all these other nations and a conspiracy against you to keep you from your true nationality, man. To keep you destroyed. Read.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
And that's what the white man said. Let us cut off black people from being a nation, man. Let us cut off these Israelites from being a nation. Let us cut off these Hispanics and these Native Americans from being a nation. Let's cut off the children of God from being a nation and let's replace them and tell them that their names are blacks, their names are Hispanics, and their names are Native Americans. And tell them that we are the children of the Most High God. A white man could never be a Jew, man.
That's right.
All right? Jesus Christ could never, ever be a white man. All right? Read.
Verse 4. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
And how did they do this? How did they cut off the real children of Israel from being a nation? By convincing them that they're not the children of Israel. By convincing them that they're nothing but niggers and spicks and savages, man. And convincing them that they are in fact the children of God. When they are not, they're the synagogue of Satan, man.
All right, bro, get ready to figure it out now, man. We're all gonna think, man. We're gonna
Brother. Sit down,
man.
Yeah, man.
I like what you guys want, man.
Yeah, man. We out here, man. I'm 26. Yeah, youngest.
Wow,
this brother, this powerful brother here, is 20 years old, man.
What? Guy, that's amazing, bro. What do you
think? Yeah, man. What's going on, brother? You got a question?
Nah, let's just look at. What religion is?
We're not a religion, alright? We are bringing back the true children of Israel. You familiar with the Bible?
Something, yeah.
Alright, so you know about the children of Israel? Chosen people of God.
Black Israelites?
Well, I'm not black, right? So it can't be black.
Yeah.
We're Israelites, right? So we're bringing back our people to the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, and the knowledge that they are the children of Israel, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Yeah. All right, so that's what we're already doing. So you're familiar with Israelites?
Israelites, Oh, can I take a picture of this one?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah. Hey, what's your nationality?
I'm Caribbean, West Indies.
Okay, you're a Benjamin, brother. All praises. You live out here?
Close.
Okay.
Alright, thank you guys.
Alright, brother.
Have a good one, yeah?
Hey, we're out here every Friday, man.
Alright, sweet.
Alright, read that.
Psalms chapter 83, verse 4. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
And that was the thing. That's what they wanted, man. They wanted it to be no more in remembrance that black people and Hispanic people are the chosen people of the Most High God. They wanted it to be no more in remembrance that the Most High God said that black people are above all people that are upon the face of the earth. They don't want that to be in remembrance anymore, man. They don't want you to remember your royal roots, man. Read on.
Verse 5. for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee.
Read.
The tabernacles of Edom.
The tabernacles of who?
Of Edom.
The tabernacles of Edom, which is you so-called white people, read.
And the Ishmaelites.
The Ishmaelites, you Arabs, read.
Of Moab.
Uh-huh.
And the Hagarenes.
Moab, you gooks, man. Read.
Gebal and Ammon and Amalek.
And that's it on that, but just to show you that the Most High God, in fact, has enemies, man. And it's every single one of these nations that is not of your nation, black man, Hispanic man, Native American man. If they don't come back to a black, Hispanic, or Native American father, they are your enemy, man. Thus saith the Bible. Alright? Go back to that thing.
First Kings chapter 8 verse 48.
Uh-huh.
And so return unto thee with all their heart.
Uh-huh.
And with all their soul in the land of their enemy.
And that's what needs to happen, man. We need to return to the Most High with all our heart, with all our soul, man. Not with our lips. You know what I want? Because that's what happens out here, man. The majority of you Christians, you blacks and Hispanics, Christians, you honor the Most High with your lips, man. But that's all it is a lip service, man. Then you go home and you're on the down low, man. Then you go home and you're selling drugs to your people, man. You go home and you're sleeping with your brother's wife. You honor the Most High with your lips, man.
This is Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13.
Read.
Wherefore the Most High said, for as much as his people draw near me with their mouth,
read,
and with their lips do honor me.
And that's what you blacks and Hispanics in the Christian church do. You draw near to the Most High with your mouth and your lips, honor the Most High. But what? Read up.
And with their lips do honor me,
uh-huh,
but have removed their heart far from me.
And that's the thing, man. You remove your heart far from the Most High. Why? Because you worship a white man. Nowhere in the Bible does it tell you to worship a goddamn white man, man. Nowhere in the Bible does it tell you to worship a damn rock. Nowhere in the Bible does it tell you to worship a woman. Alright? Go back to
1 Kings chapter 8 verse 47.
Read.
Verse 8, 48. And so return unto thee with all their heart,
uh-huh,
and with all their soul.
Read.
In the land of their enemies.
Read.
Which led them away captive,
uh-huh,
and pray unto thee toward their land, which thou gavest unto their fathers, the city which thou hast chosen,
uh-huh,
and the house which I have built for thy name.
Uh-huh.
Then hear thou their prayer and their supplication in heaven, thy dwelling place, and maintain their cause.
And that's when the Most High is going to hear you, man. And that's when the Most High is going to maintain your cause. When you bethink yourself and repent, man. That's when the Lord's gonna hear you, man. And that's when he's gonna come and save you, man. All right?